Welcome to People on Issues. It's day 5 of fasting and I want to wish you all Ramadan Kareem. I'm Razia Athman. On People on Issues, we believe that life is about people, their experiences, their triumphs, their struggles. No matter what the issues are, it always comes down to people. On the program tonight, we look at Chiboga District senior citizens. They are some of the Ugandans aged 65 years and above, entitled to the Senior Citizens Grants, a program under the Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development. They will teach you how to save, to budget and to dance. They make up the biggest percentage of Uganda's population. About half of the 37 million people are below 15 years of age. An estimated 45% falls between 15 and 60 years, and the 4.5% are those above 60 years old. These are some of the senior citizens aged 65 and above in Chiboga District, located in central Uganda, a two-hour drive from Kampala, the capital city. They are among the 105,000 beneficiaries of Senior Citizens Grants, a program under the Ministry of Gender, Labor and Social Development. That is just 10% of the population entitled to the grant by virtue of age.
Under Chiboga, we have 4,800 beneficiaries spread out in 8 sub-counties.
These are some of the 4,800 beneficiaries of the Senior Citizens Grant here in Chizinga Village, Chiboga District.
It was launched in 2011, its main funding coming from the Irish Aid, UK Aid and UNICEF. They first started handing 17,000 shillings per month to every member.
I got that money and used it to buy some goats and chicken. And I use some to help my children as well as my grandchildren. I moved a lot to look for that money and I knew my actual age, but they still didn't give me the money until later because it was not ready. But when everything was organized, they gave us 160,000 each. When I got it, I did not finish it all. Well, I bought some meat in Chibiga. I came back home, bought cement, and built a toilet.
That money, they say, was the lease of life. It lifted them off absolute poverty conditions.
It helps me. I buy salt. I pay school fees for 2 grandchildren. I also bought a mattress to sleep on. I got a blanket. I also bought goats and chicken. I bought everything, and they helped me a lot. I even applied some lotion and look good, like you can see.
They receive it through a mobile money system.
Government came up with the program paying the old, the aged people and the families which need help in some sub-counties. So MTN took the tender to pay them because it reaches down to the villages. So these machines, somebody is given a card. That card is printed with money, certain amount of money. Then that independent person, individual comes, and then we pay that person. We withdraw the money and pay the beneficiaries.
Each of them is registered, then given a card that is swiped through the machine before the cash is released.
Inside the card, then it becomes a full phone, like you have your personal phone. Then we do the normal transaction, withdraw. Then somebody's paying the money. We withdraw the money from the beneficiary to my company's agent line.
But not all is smooth with this MTN system. Sometimes there's no network to allow processing of the funds.
Each location, I mean the pay point, we go like 4 machines, and then we work like 300 people, and then you go to another location. You take like 4 machines, you go to like 200 people, And then another location, you work like 200 people with four machines again. So it kind of basically depends on where you're going and how many machines you need to, you know, to do the business.
The major challenges that we face with this program are mainly in relation with the mobile money technology. Many times, because we go deep in the villages where the senior citizens live, there isn't good network.
And that is not the only challenge Senior Citizens Grants Program is facing. The human resource is limited in terms of handling the clients. Haji Gulanyago Sabiti is 74 years old with over 30 children and 70 plus grandchildren. The grant he has been receiving is helping him survive, but for months he has not gotten his money. His card, he says, got mixed up.
My card had disappeared, but it was somewhere in the house. My voucher card. After 3 to 4 days, I notified them and told them I found the card. I went to police and reported. Then at the center where we received the money from, but they never gave me the money. When I returned, I had to beg for food because that's the money I was relying on. After 2 months, I went and saw them and they were like, you will receive all the money you've missed. And they gave me. But then again, they told me I will not receive any money until 2 years. So I asked, what is missing? Computer, phone, are there no workers? They are not responsible or what? I went back there. I didn't get anything. They said 2 years, but I will go back. I will not get tired. What hurts me is I got the card and they still didn't give me the money.
Haji Khalfan Katende is 72 years old. He's the leader of the group in Chizinga Village, Chibiga Sub-County in Chiboga District. He's a Luero Triangle War veteran.
They should register all the war veterans, everyone before.
From the money he got from the grant, he first bought a goat and now he has a whole farm. He plans wisely with the 25,000 shillings he receives every month.
With this money I drink, I get some sugar. And I have some plants because my goats are grazing. But I have them. I bought 4 of them and now there are so many. Each gave birth to 3.
Antonia Gezendoli is 64 years old. She had 8 children, but 7 of them passed away. She has 1 grandchild directly under her care. The money she receives from the senior citizens grant enabled her buy pigs and chicken.
The money has helped me educate my grandchild.
It is a program that will take time to recruit more beneficiaries, but as little as that money may seem, for the oldies, it is life-saving.
I was desperate with a lot of problems in my house. I didn't even have access to water, but I managed to buy water tanks. The little balance I have, and what I continue getting is for my 10 grandchildren at home. I'm alone. My husband died, but that money helps.
When I get that money, I first buy necessities at home like sugar and salt, and I keep the rest for the future.
There's more to their age than meets the eye.
And now a quick summary of how the program runs. We spoke to Simon Omoding. He's the communications manager for the expanding social protection program.
The program in the district is actually situated in the community development departments of all the districts where we are working. So what happens is that we have staff of the program that have been posted into the districts to work with staff of the districts. So those are the guys who run the program in the district. They are the people who register beneficiaries. They are the people who manage the day-to-day operations of the program in the district. Of course, working together with the secretariat here. So that is how the program is structured, between the center and the district.
I'm glad you're watching People and Issues on Urban TV. Let's take a short break. When we come back, an interview with the head of the Social Protection Secretariat, Stephen Kasaija.